Greetings, hello, and welcome back to some more Long War of the Chosen. And a quick little guerrilla operation in some tunnels, you know, all our favorite map.
Menace 1-5, we've got a bead on the Advent Data Vault near your position. Be advised.
Be advised? What was that? Why would you... Sorry, my game just decided that it really wants to be in the background. Oh no, that's not good. Alright, I know what happened. I don't like when that happened. So, yeah, all good. I think self-detonating charges are in place. Kill all enemies. That's what Bradford was trying to tell us.
You don't have to tell me twice.
No, because I just previously played the Ever mission and we took a photo there, and I'm syncing the photo booth folder to a Google Drive folder so that everybody can look at the photo booth shots. Google just told me, hey, there's a new photo in there. And it thought that it would need to make a pop-up for that that grabs focus from the game.
Yep.
Like, why would
just
you do that?
Like
he did. Also, why does XCOM always... there's no option in XCOM to still play sound when the game is in the background. Like, I appreciate it that it doesn't play sound when it's in the background, but I also would really prefer it to be optional at the same time. Anyway,
nearing strike range.
It looks like there's not much happening right now.
Already there.
But let's not be too aggressive here.
All this walking's wearing me out.
Maybe a little bit aggressive.
Can't wait.
Get him there.
You even got a thing, got a stock and everything, a spider suit. We're rich now, huh?
Ready to fire. We have eyes on the target.
A longbow and a not so longbow, okay. Mooney is rocket tech. So that might be a viable opening. We also do have an acid grenade. Let me get some eyes on there.
So, you're gonna bark all day? Hey, cupcake, come on over here.
Okay. That's a big pot. Just wondering if we can somehow even like activate that this turn. Well, that feels a little bit rushed. I don't think that's two groups. It's two groups, not one group. So while they're grouped up, firing that rocket over there seems like a really good choice. But that also leaves me with very few options. So I could teamwork command, then I have a double move, get into a good position, rockets ahoy. Then I have two shots here. I could even go in there and soulstorm whatever's left with no way of getting back out. And you have a running gun with a potential stun gun, and you have a potential for having no shots. Depending on how they move, we could like grapple up here and snipe something. Hmm. You know what? What else do we have? Volkswagen, get some does not have any effect on Rocket's crit, so that's kind of pointless.
Looks like you could use some muscle.
Question is, where do we want to go for the rocket? Do we want to go here? We want to go back there? We don't have javelin. Want to go here? I'm a little concerned that that box might be in the way, but you know, I think that's fine.
As long as this world is plagued by demons, my hunt will continue.
Okay, so at the moment that's 2.52 tiles average scatter. Feels a little bit big. Come on. 0.66 tiles, everything's in radius.
Feel my wrath. Let none survive.
Do that, okay. I have to try this.
You shouldn't have come.
I should have fused the first sergeant first. And leaves us with a mech and two drones here. Fortunately, not quite in line of sight here for anybody. We're gonna take some damage here. If I can't line up that trench gun, I would be super disappointed. If I can't get both of these kills, I'd also be disappointed. Yeah, so I'm definitely leaving that drone alive and not the mech. But you know, unless I miss that shot, then both are alive.
Sir, I have visual on the object. Permission to approach.
Yeah, there's no way I'm getting line of sight on anything here. Let's see what the AI does with this. Well, it pulls in some more people. Triple Snake, Naja, double Sidewinder. Of course, course you could take a shot.
I am under fire.
You're coming in for the flank. Two points of real damage. Ooh, and a stun. Stun definitely not in the right position for my taste. Thinking we're going down here, flank this snake, probably stun gun this one, and then we do something about you. Problem is what we do without these two. But you can certainly take a shot at this thing. Maybe we're just gonna have to Reaper that? Maybe even both. I don't know yet. What's my damage here? Probably not 15. Yeah. Hang on.
Enemies down.
What say you and I do a little dance? We gotta hit him now. Death sure does suit you.
Part of me just wants to continue this good tradition of rockets. I don't think we can do much about you though. I'm wondering if I take the shotgun shot here. Grapple. And then I might be able to Reaper that to get the kill. Or we could just roll max damage crit now. Yeah, I think we can get the kill there. A little bit risky since we're gonna reveal some more territory over there. We're not done yet.
Closing on target. I'm a friend.
What? He's a friend. Okay. I think the idea is to stun gun you then. Oh, we take a shot. 59 doesn't feel great. What's my backup plan? Do I have a backup plan? Do you get line of sight on blade? You do. So we could throw another command at the problem.
Yep, I've got it.
So idea is take shot. Come in with the knifey boy here. which totally does not get, hey, my buddy shot out at it, because they are only level 1 buddies, so that was completely wasted shot there. Yeah, and if all fails, we're not getting the kill with the 2, then I can command and stun gun and fail to get the kill there too. That seems like a good deal. My browser tab, that was my Discord, not yours. Stop pinging me when I'm recording. Anyway. I don't like this, so probably gonna break line of sight here, go to the sides, etc. Before we do that though, we need to do slash here. Me? Yeah, you can't get a shot. Well, that's fine. We can just dedicate.
Approaching target now. I think that's it.
I mean, there's no way that snake has line of sight to him, right? So I don't have to worry about this.
I depart. That should prove useful.
All right, that's it. That's it. I'm gonna mute that browser tab there. Okay. Take line of sight. Get ready to flank from that doorway. Raid out.
Overwatch.
Overwatch. I'm kinda thinking if I can get you to that door, that would be really nice. You're having 3 people with a grappling hook here in the squad. A grappling hook. Has its advantages. Even in the sewers, tunnels, whatever it is, man. I should also really throw an evac like 5 turns ago. Active free, so that probably means the snake moved to whatever other group there is that is out there and activated. Or whatever, joined them or whatever you want to call it. Let's do a pass by here just to see if we can see anything. Just take the good old advice of gathering your party before venturing forth. We don't have a ranged hack, right? That's, you know, the topic of this campaign. You thought it was no plasma weapons? No, no, it's no hacking.
Stand by me.
Also, it's not no plasma weapons anymore.
Don't start none.
I've got your back, you've got mine. Do not test my patience.
hangs out.
Got him.
These idiots again.
Okay, didn't get him. Alright, Longbow, Elite, and Viper Serpents. And reinforcements. Okay. How close is that? 0.84 on average. Shouldn't hit the box. Also didn't hit the Naja. Okay, we got lightning reflexes, so you can run the mech overwatch. Alternatively, we can also snipe the mech.
Hard target, minimal damage.
How do I get rid of all of you this turn? So I think we're gonna come in, slice you a little bit. I do have one run and gun here, right? Which can reach. Oh, yeah. Is that. Yeah, Blade has 18 mobility. Oh my god. That's kind of convenient to have. So I can reach anything, right? We just need to flank this snake, that's fine. I'd really like Thomas to be on Overwatch for the reinforcements. Which means we need to kill. Probably just set that snake on fire. Then run and gun this guy. While flanking the snipey snake.
For you if we make it out of here.
Come on! So we have one good overwatch for the reinforcements here.
These idiots again.
Rocketeer and Rocketeer. Got the Rocketeer. Only have to deal with Rocketeer then. I'm so certain that these guys used to have, they have a poison spit, I'm fairly certain. Yeah, but I've always seen them double run away, never using the poison. I don't know. Which makes it sometimes easier, harder to catch up with them. But in a way also easier. What do we do with you, buddy?
Voices in your head.
Can I go hack the objective first, or do I need to kill you first? Okay, I can go hack.
You shouldn't have come.
Get him! You see that damage? Ballistic SMG? Strongest weapon in the game at the moment.
I'm going in.
Now, thankfully, there's not anything super important here. It's so close to getting the large of my cache.
Venice 1-5, status confirmed. The charges are inactive and the package is secure. Eliminate any remaining hostiles near the AO.
That is impossible.
Double time it.
You've got like what? Two turns, three turns until evac comes.
Sir, I have visual on the object. Troops are on mission to approach.
Himko. Nice, nice, nice. Okay.
That's affirmative.
Shotgun to the face.
Dead and gone.
Let's get to the evac, let's get out of here. At the end of the day, similar to the smash and grab, one person injured.
I depart.
In motion.
I'm going in.
Which may or may not have been avoidable. I'm not gonna. Not gonna be too strict there.
We've got company.
Yeah, we've got company. It's kind of the thing with Soulstorm, I'm not convinced yet that it's actually really good. It feels like, you know, it's a bit like Firestorm from the technical, except you're not leaving smoke for yourself, you're not destroying cover, you're not putting enemies on fire so they don't shoot back at you, and you can't use it with Quick Burn. But other than that, it's great.
On my way.
Good. I was hoping to get in some target practice.
Wonderful.
Shot one.
Almost had one. He's burning.
This is Firebrand. It's time to go.
You shouldn't have come.
Can't leave a guy burning, right? That's just inhumane.
No more trouble.
Right. See ya.
About time I got out of this place. Let's go.
Avenger, this is Firebrand. Package is secure. All XCOM operatives are secure. Firebrand is returning to base.
So I think if I had used, what's it called again, fuse first to explode the first sergeant's
Commander
grenade, it might have been enough to kill him.
Up to those who would abandon our values for those of the old world. The remarkable
marks followed a moment of silence for peacekeepers slain by XCOM dissidents.
Maybe there would have been a better spot. The thing is, it leaves you so vulnerable, right? You get into a position like that, you do the Soulstorm. It's like you can basically only use it when you've already won anyway. It's not an ability to give you an advantage, it's more like a cleanup ability. And there's so many cleanup abilities. And in that point, at that point, I can also just pop Reaper, run in there and kill everything. If I have it available, that's a safer option. So I'm not a fan of Soulstorm so far. I want to have my winged lance instead.
Apart one mission at a time, Commander. Impressive work.
Well, you are going to be. Let's do Death on the Roof for a change. No other promotions. You actually have a. You could. Yeah. No. Absolutely. Bond up. Okay, yeah. No, take photo. Get back. And also no promotion there. Well, that was, considering most of this is really just, hey, I want to get some promotions for my guys. Side PCS though, I think we were lacking those. Okay, so that's now puts us here at that troop column. What was this? This was a get advance attention? Yeah, okay, we're not doing that.
Setting course for Sector 13, South Africa.
So, quick look over here. Oh, they're still on covert action for 4 hours. I'm also thinking that I'm probably going to rather use this squad for the UFO, which is coming in 24 hours or so. So we might just use these guys again for the troop column, with some support probably from tea time or so. Because I wanna have an officer, right? And I wanna have a support grenadier for the frost bomb. You're a regular grenadier, or rather a separate grenadier. That's not gonna work for me. You guys are on a mission right now. Why both of these 4 days and 5 days? Is it really still that long until I get my UFO? I don't know. Don't ask me that. I thought it was like a day after the covert action finishes. Yeah, okay, let's grab V. And we're gonna have to thin out a little bit. As much as I wanna take as many as possible from the squad, we're going up against the Archon King. I can't bring like low ranking guys. That's already Tech Sergeant, Staff Sergeant is already cutting it close. But I think the whole light him up shredder puts you into a good position. I might have to give you a proper rifle though. Alright, just let's find then some people to put in there. And that's also a mission I'm gonna boost. Let's run Spanner there for some sniper support. Just not sure if we're actually gonna hit the Archon King good enough that cyclic fire will be of value. But I mean, there could also be other stuff on the mission. What else was I waiting for here? No, I don't think we're gonna pick up Flesh, but probably gonna pick up either Lone Wolf or more likely Damn Good Ground to work on that aim. Yeah, we've got 10 AP, just pick up DGG. In the slums, so that should also give us opportunity for some damn good ground. Okay, I'm just gonna... I was going to say, yeah, we can equip the squad here. That should be fine. So you get a scoped rifle. You switch over to the warsuit if it's available. No, okay. You're actually fairly healthy already. And you know what? Get a conditioning PCS on top of that. We want to bring the frost bomb. And that seems good enough. You're gonna get some real armor, you're gonna get a real shotgun. And I think some real ammo. How expensive is an arc? Whatever it's called. Arc Blaster, Arc Thrower, Arc Pistol Mark II. Advanced Arc Thrower. 21-3. Yeah, we can afford that. So we've got the disabling shot, we've got the Arc Thrower. Should and we have the frost bomb. That's enough to keep the guy stunned for a while. You've got the grazing fire. I'm gonna give you a mind shield because if we end up for some reason in the devastate of the Archon King, that prevents you from getting stunned. And same thing for you. As much as I would like to give you a subcorner, I really don't think we need it. How are we looking on... I don't think we have Archon corpses to build more fusion blades, do we? We do. The other alternative is... The expensive alternative is to upgrade that axe for the instant throw, additional stun chance. That's so expensive, that fusion axe. Alright, let's go with the level 2 axe.
Maybe a little unwieldy, but in the right hands, this thing should cut down anything standing in your way.
Your mom's a little unwieldy. Anyway. Could give you some agility. $34 dodge, that's not terrible. Maybe Infighter doesn't work for slicing. Lightning reflexes might not be the worst. Resilience. Here's an interesting idea. If I give you resilience, you don't need a nanoscale vest, right? Because I have the crit resistance from this. Then I can give you something else, which we don't have right now. Like a hazmat vest or so. We don't have any hacking, and we're not gonna get any reduced enemy numbers. It's true, gun. We could run into a gatekeeper, we could run into a sector pod, or we could just have a good time. I thought I would get that squad setup done faster, so sorry for keeping it in the episode this time. I hope it's not the end of the world. Okay. So yeah. I think it was just showing they were infiltrating for 4 more days, because that's what they need to actually get to 100%. But yeah, that's also something we're gonna boost. I think we made a lot of intel from missions and collector and getting it from the various regions. I thought I boosted two I boosted two missions last time while we were at around 200. Now we're already at 200 again, just for mission rewards, skulljacking, hacking rewards, and all that other good stuff. Okay, Here's a side question. What regions are we actually running missions in? Where do we want to scan? Because it all looks awful. We're also not running... not doing any bond training right now. Just having a quick look if any one of those says level 2 reached. Level 3 reached. This looks like... Dirty was tired anyway, right? Yeah, let's do that. But I think they don't recover tiredness during bond training. Let's actually do Jet and Marco for level 2. I think I'm gonna scan in Western US, because there we still also have a chance to get some supply trains, supply rates.
Our action together is complete, Commander.
That worked out well. Carry on. We built the ring facility.
The factions have ready proposals for various covert missions. We should head to the ring to plan our next stop.
Okay, Master Sergeant Grenadier. Lots of interesting choices. Probably gonna be full kit, right? To have more stink grenades available to stun more enemies. Ghost grenade is great. Sapphire is not really relevant for you. Yeah, kit for you. I was looking here. We've got 12 AP. Do we just take close personal? Because what else are we gonna take? Or we might just not take anything. And down here, tech sergeant. Well, that's a good question. It's fairly little reason to take coolant under pressure. Oh, come on. Sorry, my. Cool drive is acting up. I need to make sure that it doesn't do that anymore. Okay, so no point taking cool under pressure. We don't have Overwatch skills, we're not gonna take that. Not with 73 aim at that rank. I guess we can bring a medkit and then our medkits do 4 more healing. Or we just take failsafe. I think we just take failsafe. Be a little bit more aggressive with hacking stuff with you. I'm really wondering if I want to pick up Head of Bullets here just to have some shooting utility. I mean, fortify is great, but you know, yeah, let's just pick that up. And I'm also thinking we're gonna throw somebody into the next chosen operation here. And I mostly have in my eyes currently on anyone. I was going to say in tea time. But they don't really have Master Sergeants yet. Okay, maybe this one then. Yeah, since we're doing bond training there, Dirty is tired. The other guys are out on the on the mission on this troop column. I'm not having the right words where they belong in my head right now. I'm sorry, I'm stumbling over my own tongue the whole time. Okay, who else do we pick? Well, I actually don't think we have anyone else from Tea Time available here. Now, I don't think it's gonna work if I just take low ranking guys, right? What's the failure chance then? None. Well, guys. That could be an interesting ambush if it comes that far. I shouldn't take a sharpshooter then. We did have someone else back there, down there, right? One of the psyops. no reason to not give them at least some decent equipment. Think about your weapon in a second. Let me see. I mean, at the moment you're a grenadier without really any skills here. I can't buy from this screen. I was going to buy him a fire grenade at least. Let's take the gas. Yeah, you need an SMG type weapon. There we go. Seems reasonable. Allocate that.
We'll get the job done. Don't worry, Commander.
Alright, and with that, we're gonna keep on scanning. Yeah, you're gonna go out on the mission in a day here anyway, so no point starting that officer training. But that's gonna be our first max rank officer, and that's then combined arms, which is really strong. And this is... find enemy flight paths, 13 to 15, with 5 people. Okay. Let me just. I wanna check something here. Resistance management, Western US. It's still strength 4. I'm surprised that it didn't go down. Okay, that's a tough nut. But we get a UFO mission from that, right? So I'm still gonna try it. Do our best. Give it a best shot. And see what we get, but we're gonna see that in the next episode. Thanks for watching. See you next time.